Maybe you've heard of the DP-300 exam, or maybe you haven't. Well, if you're a database professional and looking at the cloud, you're definitely going to want to tune in and learn all about DP-300 and the certification to get certified, pass the exam, learn all the tips and tricks, and learn why you might want to take this. This week on Data Exposed. Hi, I'm Anna Hoffman, and welcome to this episode of Data Exposed. Today, we're going to be talking about getting skilled up, and I'm super excited. I have Julianne joining us. Julianne, thanks so much for joining us today. Can you kick us off by telling us a little bit about what you do?
Yeah, Anna, thanks for having me. I'm Julianne Padron. I'm a senior content developer in worldwide learning, and I work in the data and AI team.
Awesome. Cool. Well, it's great to have you on the show. You're the perfect person to tell us all about DP-300. So before we lose anybody, like, let's back up and say, like, what is DP-300 and why is it important for folks that watch this show, mostly like database professionals?
Right. The DP-300 exam is also known as Administering Microsoft Azure SQL Solutions. This is a certification exam. It's part of the Azure Database Administrator Associate certification path. So this exam is mainly designed to assess the knowledge and skills of database professionals in managing database in Microsoft Azure platform. Even if you are an experienced DBA in the field or if you just have starting your journey, so it's the certifications for you. So it's also, I would say, it's also provide an opportunity to gain in-depth knowledge about Azure SQL database, Azure SQL managed instance, and SQL Server running on Azure VMs. So awesome. Responding to your question about why DP-300 is important, the way I think it validates someone's skills and expand their knowledge base and ultimately positions them for career growth and success in the field of Azure Database Administration.
Awesome. Yeah, I definitely agree. I've seen a lot of people go through and take this exam. In a way, like, an exam can also be a forcing function. So you learn and you prepare. But, you know, as people think about or consider the DP-300 exam, like, what are some of the key topics and how do they relate to real world type of solutions?
Right. Before we dive into that, let's just go back a little bit. So just to explain how you can get certified. So let's review the path. So your certification journey for Azure Database Administrator Associates is right here, right? You may have taken Azure Fundamentals or even Azure Data Fundamentals exam, which are optional, by the way, but we highly recommend them. And after taking those certifications, you may take an either self-paced online training or even the structure-led training that we offer. But not to say that we also offer a variety of resources, that being hands-on labs, documentation, practice tests, and most recently, the exam prep guides we put in place, and we're going to talk a little bit about that. So after you take your self-study, and I would say you do your self-assessment because you need to understand where you are in your learning journey and what are the gaps that you need to fill in, you should be able to take the next step, which is the exam.
Nice. Cool. Okay. I like the path. All right. So now, what are some of the key things that people will learn by studying for this and how does it relate?
Right. The topics covered in the DP-300, there are main five topics or pillars that we talked about. And those are directly relevant to the real world scenarios we are discussing in a database administration world. So the first one is the plan implement data platform resources. In this group, we focus on deploying Azure SQL resources and components and migration options and scenarios. The second one, implement a secure environment. We focus on implement SQL Server-based options for authentication authorization for all of our Azure SQL offerings, including encryptions, firewall, advanced threat protection. And the third one, monitor, configure, and optimize database resources. We focus on comparing Azure and on-premise tools for monitoring and measuring performance. So choosing an appropriate size and storage options for Azure SQL databases, also reviewing some of the monitoring tools that we have, Azure SQL Insights, Query Performance Insights, and a few others. We also have Configure and Manage Automation of Tasks. So here we focus on multiple deployment models available in Azure and how to evaluate different strategies for monitoring automation tasks. And last but not least, we have the planning, configuring high availability and disaster recovery environment. We focus on implementing an appropriate HADR strategy based on recovery time objective, recovery point objective, and also choosing the best solution for IaaS and PaaS deployment or even hybrid workloads as well.
Nice. It feels like a pretty comprehensive set of topics for, you know, like the Azure DBA. Now, this exam has been around for a while, at least a couple of years, I think. What are some of the, you know, most recent changes that have happened?
Yeah, I have listed here the four main changes that happened recently. The first one was the exam name. We changed the exam name around December last year. And then we also increased the scope for migration, right? So most of our customers and learners will say we need to increase the scope for migration. We are migrating our workloads. How does that work? So they wanted that topic to be included more in depth. So we did that as well. And also we increased the scope for hybrid features with SQL Server 2022. We now have so many cool features and hybrid features, right? So we also included that in the DP-300. And the last one would be the automation content, right? When you're talking about the real world scenarios, DevOps, so many components for many industries that it's really relevant to understand how automation means for the database scenarios, right? Like Elastic Jobs, Azure Automation, Logic App, and include all of those database tasks in a workflow pipeline for deployment.
Nice. Awesome. Okay. That's good to know. My final question, maybe you can't tell us, but maybe you can, like, let's say I'm studying, I'm prepping for DP-300. Like, can you give me some tips and tricks, anything I should know that will help me pass?
Absolutely. I think the main thing that I would say is that our official learning paths and modules, so they were designed specifically for DP-300 for Azure database certification, right? So it's really important you go through that and try to absorb as much as we can. We have hands-on labs as well that you can practice. We have even a Microsoft and Azure subscription free for you where you can log in and you can try your labs on your own, on your free subscription to practice everything that you learn in the module. The next thing I would say is the press test and exam prep guides. We recently launched something called Exam Readiness Zone. This is where our exam prep videos are. So when we're talking about the five main pillars, you're going to have one video for each of those topics. So it will range between 30 minutes and an hour. Those are really a good starter if you think of taking your career to the next level, learn what your gaps in your learning are. So that's a really good place to start. We also have the Microsoft official documentation, right? We can stress that enough to keep you updated on many features that we have. And last but not least, build experience with technology, right? I mean, the hands-on practice can never be, you know, outlier or something like that. You need to do the hands-on practice so you can really absorb all the concepts that you learn.
Definitely. Yeah, I think these are great tips for not just passing the exam, but also just learning the content and feeling more comfortable with Azure SQL and all the other Azure-y things that a DBA might need to know. Julian, thanks so much for coming on the show. I personally learned a lot. I think our viewers learned a lot, and they know where to go to learn even more. So to our viewers, check the link in the description to learn more. Leave us a comment and let us know your biggest ways that you're preparing for DP-300 and what you think. And we hope to see you next time on Data Exposed.